The big red lights on Grace Jones with William's Blood on BBC Radio 6 Music. Ladies and gentlemen, it's mellow. It's Christmas. Gillian McKeith's Christmas album. So driving home for Christmas, I can't wait to see their feces joke.
Oh, OK. I thought you were going for Yule log or something.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, come on. Yeah. What do you expect?
That works too. That works too.
Great threesome.
No one's cried yet. I feel a little bit almost shortchanged by the fact that you haven't wept.
I haven't had a complete physical and mental breakdown yet.
Apart from the one that we've experienced and been listening to for the past 12 years.
I know. It's like watching a car crash. It was very, very slow motion, isn't it? I'm gonna deploy the Rockford Files theme tune here for the last time. So
it's very much your free bird, very much your creep in the set, isn't it?
Do Rockford Files, mate, come on! Come on, it's 9:10, mate! And when I do it, though, if for the people that know it, I want you to put Man in a Caravan in there very loudly, OK? Is that possible? It might have been 7 or 8 people who will do that with me, but let's try it. It was underwhelming, but I'm still glad I did.
That's because no one saw the programme and has any idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, it's an unusual programme. We've talked about this before. It's a late middle-aged man living in a caravan on the coast, occasionally solving crimes. Very lonely. Very lonely man. He looks broken to me. You know, right, what was it? Not James Cagney. James...
Garner.
Yeah.
I do look a bit like him.
You
You're
do. I mean,
right.
I'm about to say the parallels between the life of that character and you are not inconsiderable.
No, absolutely true. We're overwhelmed, is what we are. We're not even doing any middle-aged shout-outs. It's sad but true. We've just simply not got around to it. We will have to cover that off because it's contractual, isn't it?
Do you want one? I can get you one.
All right. Just get that for production. Isn't that incredible, that? Oh, Matt Hill says, just tuned in for the final Dead Zone. Thanks to you and the rest of the team for the daily drivel. Isn't that lovely? Absolutely lovely. We do have some actual featurettes coming up on the programme, including, we are very, very shortly going to be graced by the presence of one of the great presenters and a woman who is going to be taking the clammy baton from my breakfast hand, covered in croissant dust as it is. No, hang on a minute. There's no need for that. I accept that the phrase clammy baton is not the actual high watermark of my broadcasting career. Oh, sorry about that. It's really just look at the. Oh my God. What an incredible dress. Nobody's even mentioned mine. Off the shoulder halter neck job. But Lauren's absolutely killing it. And we're going to be talking to her very shortly in the last half hour of the programme. The last sector of the Kate Moss Hour, of course, we are going to be getting Christmased to the max. It's going to be more Christmassy than a pint of eggnog, ladies and gentlemen. Ed Harcourt sings the songs of Christmas. But now, ooh, look at him. Sid Rim.
Yeah.
acid rim. Doubt and deny more on BBC Radio 6 Music. The old dear Christmas party trundles on. I'm running out of steam now, I tell you that. So I need a colossal cry for help from the audience here in Maida Vale 7. Hello, everybody! Are you excited about Christmas and that? No. Look at that. That is a true middle-aged approach to Christmas, isn't it? Oh, must be bloody joking, mate. Yo, middle-aged. Let's do a couple of these quickly. Paula in Cornwall says, I'm off to drive the school minibus, so we'll miss the end of your show. Catch up on the Sounds app. It's the end of an era. On the school minibus? That doesn't scan, does it?
All right.
Oh, no, I've read it wrong. I can't read my own writing. Let me try it again. Here we go. Ready? 2, 3, 4. It's the end of us. On the school minibus. That was a bit better. And then Doreen and Martin say, I've got a middle-aged shout-out. I'm going to Christmas shop and lining my cake tin to bake my cake. So exciting. Enjoy your Christmas party at the legendary Maida Vale Studios. We're on springs, ladies and gentlemen. Fruitcake's pretty heavy, so have an alcoholic bevy.
Please, drink responsibly.
Okay, now... Now, my little legends, it is time to introduce a woman who has actually been my broadcast partner one way or another for over a million years. We briefly did a show together standing in for the Zipper Zine Low. It's so bloody hot right now. And it went so well, that first show, that after the first show, our then boss pulled me to one side and said, Mike, you need to talk much less in the next broadcast. That's how it went. She's done the bloody lot, from Desert Island Disco to Desert Island Discs, from the Culture Show, which is not a show about Indian flatbreads, to singing the hits with Kenicky, Mint Royale and Divine Comedy. She is Radio Royalty, and she's taking over from me. She's taking my clammy baton in January. She's doing the bloody breakfast show. She must be nuts. Can we have a colossal round of applause for Lauren Laverne?
Shaun, thank you.
Well, I thunked to myself, I write lyrical and slightly verbose and slightly too long and get a bit boring introductions for everybody else. You've not had one yet.
Never.
So I thought I'd anoint you with one.
I'm extremely touched. Did you know what I was remembering while you were saying that as well? Do you remember when I got together with my now husband, who I've been with for about, must be coming up to 20 years, 18 years or something like that, and you smelled his aftershave on my parka? We were doing a show together on the Saturday morning, and Shaun's walking around the studio, like, sniffing, going, I can smell Givenchy pour on.
I'm glad you remember that.
He was Givenchy boy for about, like, 10 years, I think.
He's such a great...
Now. Every now and again, he still is.
Every now and again. My olfactory senses are the last things to go.
Extremely keen.
Extremely keen.
Yeah.
I'm glad we have, though.
Like
we've
a
had some. Very much. I mean, if you hide a croissant in Maida Vale, I will find it within 7 minutes. but what can we say? I mean, we have, you know, man and boy, we've been together doing all this kind of stuff, and I've been handing over to you for what must be 9 years now.
Yeah.
And now you're doing breakfast.
I know.
And what, you've done it before. You've done it at a previous radio station that shall remain nameless, 104.9 XFM. How unprofessional of me. But why are you doing it?
Well, I mean, it's exciting, isn't it? I think we've all been part of Six Music's growth as a family. You know, Six Music is a different radio station from any other that I've worked at, in that it is such a kind of community of people, including the listeners, you know, the presenters, that so many of us are kind of friends, and we've known each other and been part of each other's lives in one way and another for a really long time. And then obviously having gone through what Six went through, you know, when it was saved by its listeners, that created a very special relationship between us and them. And I think kind of watching the station grow and become that family become bigger has been really interesting. So to get the chance to then go, okay, well, where next? You know, what can we do next is a really wonderful, lovely, exciting privilege. It's scary. I mean, it's scary. I'm like looking at all the tweets, you know, everybody was sending you yesterday, and thank you so much for the most fantastic 11 years. You've been absolutely brilliant, and you know how much I love you as a person, but also as a broadcaster. I was looking at these tweets last night thinking, like, oh my God, so I'm filling in for Kirsty on Desert Island Discs and now stepping into Shaun's shoes. I mean, like, that's that as tough briefs go, I've got two massive pairs of clown shoes to fill. Absolutely enormous. So I'm excited and I'm nervous and I'm really looking forward to it. And I'm excited for you as well. I'm excited to hear what you do in your new slot.
I don't know. We haven't got a bloody clue what we're doing yet. But I mean, you'd be pleased to know probably. But I think you're right. You know, it's always difficult, isn't it? Because as radio lovers, you immediately can spot another radio head, basically. Somebody else who's as obsessed with the medium as you are, and you're one. And all the boys and girls at Six Music are complete radio obsessives, basically. We understand the connection with the audience is so strong, really. So I just think it's so lovely that none of us are going anywhere.
Yeah.
You know, it is like a cabinet reshuffle, isn't it? It is like somebody said, it's like moving the TV table from under the sort of bay window across to the other side of the bedroom. But it seems to me, and this is something that my listeners will not be used to, and they'll have to get used to it, that you've got some actual features on your new breakfast show.
Well, we've got a few. I mean, obviously, we're not planning too hard because we are going in there with a kind of tone and a feel. And obviously, as always with my shows, music is at the heart of it. You know, it's about kind of curating that mix, and it's a bit like making a mixtape for a mate every day, you know, and obviously you give them a different one on a Monday than you would on a Friday. So being aware of all that kind of stuff. And yes, definitely we have features, but I think you also want to leave space and room for collaboration. Yeah. I think what's lovely about your show and what you've done with this time of day is that it feels so kind of intimate and people feel, you know, that they want to get involved and they want to kind of speak to you. And we definitely don't want to lose that. You know, we want everybody to feel welcome. That's for me, like the number one thing. It's reception at the Six Music Hotel. Everyone come in, you know, we'll get you a nice frothy coffee. That's sit it. Down, like take a load.
Can
off.
I see the pillow menu, please? You'll be needing that, Lauren, I'll tell you that much. Yeah. And just for the listeners who are concerned, because it's a little bit like methadone, you know, coming off a certain drug, you will still be playing a decent amount of Zeppelin, won't you?
Because always.
A lot of missives about that. Well, who's going to... I mean, what about the Zeppelin quotient? Okay. I mean, you know. So, okay. you know, you start high and then just taper it off. You know, you've got to bring them slowly off that.
I mean, you took like one every half hour?
I'd say to start with, and then one an hour, and then one a show, and then away you go. You know, just for the first 6 weeks. And, you know, sort of, have you bought a new alarm clock and that? You're used to it because you have done it before.
Well, also, I have got two very small children, but I don't want to spoil anyone's fun because people are enjoying telling me how tired I'm going to be. So I'm essentially going to be getting up at the same time, but just coming to work earlier. So yes, I've got two alarm clocks who've been very effective for the last 11 years.
It ain't going to be a problem sleeping in, is it? No, let's be perfectly honest. And what we're going to do now is we're going to play some Chemical Brothers. Can you tell us a little bit about some of the things that we can expect? Can you tease us with some of the things that might be happening in the first few weeks?
That might be happening in the first few weeks. Well, I think we may be getting a little bit of a visit from Chems, hoping to be doing something with them. We've got a special project planned. We have got some really lovely features, opportunities for the audience to get involved. I'm quite excited about a feature that we've got called House Music that we are enjoying. This came from... I was doing the hoovering the other weekend and I realised that as I struck up my hoover with my foot, or my vacuum cleaner, I should say, that it played the opening glissando from Chic's Good Times. It struck me as really ironic because the sound of your hoover is never, it never kind of heralds good times, does it? And I tweeted about it, and then it turned out that Household Appliances are playing so many tunes to Six Music listeners like you wouldn't believe. So a lot of coffee machines that do White Stripes covers. So, example, the hardest button to button.
Yes.
So we're going to be inviting Six Music listeners to tell us what the appliances in their lives
that's
are performing
brilliant.
And then get their track on air.
I think that's somebody's phone starting up. In fact, that is true because my rubbish old laptop, whenever I pressed the wrong button, which was often, would play the opening stanza to Trample Underfoot by the aforementioned Led Zeppelin. So I'll be submitting that. Thank you so much for coming in and chatting to us. I hope you have a brilliant, brilliant Christmas party here afterwards. I promise we will clear up. There's a slip risk over there because I spread some WD-40 by accident on the floor. We'll clean it up. But for now, ladies and gentlemen, Lauren Laverne! And they are Desert Island Disco, Chemical Brothers, first Friday in the new year on Lauren's show. Do not miss it. Here they are with The Golden Path.
as I walked along the supposed golden path, I was confronted by a mysterious specter. He pointed to the graveyard over on yonder hill. I paused in cosmic reflection, confused and wondering of how I came to die. I was confused, for if I was dead, how and why did I die? But I composed myself and decided I should face it. But I stood paralyzed on the supposed golden path, and I was confronted by a powerful demon force. And he said he was the devil, and when he spoke, his words flowed like glowing lava from the mouth of a volcano. And I said, help me, Lord.
Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord.
I found myself in some kind of hell. But I did not believe in a heaven and hell, world in opposites kind of reality. And I gained control of myself, and I decided to press on. As I walked along the supposed golden path, I was trembling with fear. Oh, the lions and wizards yet to come, I seen in the distance silver mountains rising high in the clouds, and a voice from above did whisper some shining answer from the moon.
I'm bloody exhausted, I tell you. I'm wiped out, Phil. I'm wiped out, mate.
Happy, Shaun, happy birthday. Hey, Shaun, happy bro. Christmas. Hey, Shaun, happy New Year's Thanks, Day. Man. Happy Valentine's Day. Easter. I hope you don't get too drunk this summer. Everything is covered, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are in MV7 for the Christmas party. Yes! Lauren Laverne is up next. Yes! Then it's going to be Rab Max, Stuart's going to be in, and then it's capping it off with a colossal ones and twos DJ fabulousness set is going to be Mr. Steve Lamack, which is going to be superb as well. We are extraordinarily excited and not a little bit overstressed. And on the remote microphone right now, fresh from reception, is Mr. Matt Everett.
Are you there? That remote, it's got a cable on it.
You can't go that far then.
No, we can't.
We couldn't run to one of those battery packs, could we?
No. No budget.
It probably is worth just getting... I mean, please do not swear. It's probably worth having a chat to some of the great and good that are here who've been with us, some of them, through the thin and even thinner on this breakfast show. Could you talk to some of them before the news?
Who's been here since the very, very start? Can anyone put their hand up that's been here since...
What, first child?
Day one. No one's been here. So we're not going to speak to anyone.
Okay,
so
we'll just go straight to the news.
I'm just going to go...
It's not a problem, is it?
Hello.
Hello.
And your name is?
My name is Tom. I'm from up-and-coming listener hotspot Cambridge.
Cambridge, of course, home of Cambridge Analytica, ladies and gentlemen. Let's not forget that. What are you wearing? Tell you what I'm wearing. I'm wearing yellow budgie smugglers. Sells more, Tom.
Where does it come from? So, what does the Breakfast Show mean to you, personally?
Just, it helps me tolerate the morning.
Tolerate?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it just gets me through the first couple of hours of the day with...
That's how I feel. Exactly, exactly that is how I feel. You could frame that.
Gets you through. Hello.
Hello.
And your name is?
Catherine, also from Cambridge.
Oh, see?
It's a double Cambridge. I mean, have you been thinking about how you're going to deal with the loss? Obviously, we have Lauren coming in, but this is going to be difficult for many people, I think.
Make it emotional.
Yeah, it's going to be tough. It's going to be tough. But, you know, I'll make it through. I'll make it through. Don't quite know how. Don't know if Lauren might be a bit too chirpy in the morning.
No, she won't be. But she knows this. Give her 6 weeks.
No, we'll make it through. I think, you know, with all of us together, we'll make it through. Yeah.
That's the kind of Dunkirk spirit that makes me want to cry.
Really hello.
And hi.
How long have you been listening?
Oh, about...
2 hours now.
Hey!
About 8 years.
Eight years.
Yeah, and it's been epic. I've loved you guys and the whole show, the whole production team. Amazing.
Why?
It's such a laugh. And the music is epic. And I just love all the cartwheels. Dirk and Jürgen, yeah. Everyone, just superb. And congratulations, Matt, on your little...
Thank you.
Wait a minute.
What?
I completely echo those sentiments. And I must say, this seems to be the perfect time to finally hear from Mr. Mick Hucknall.
Or not.
Listen, this is... I mean, you're determined to make me go, and it's very possible that in the second half of the Kate Moss hour, I will.
I hope so.
More cloying self-regard that I'm going to direct up my own fundament in the last half of the Kate Moss hour, the last sixth of the show for the Fraction fans. Thank you very much, Matt, and to my beautiful listeners. But right now it is 9:30, which means that, can you believe it, it is time for the news.
Six Music.
This is BBC Radio.
Six Music.
BBC News. Theresa May is meeting with the French President Emmanuel Macron in Brussels as she continues to seek amendments to her Brexit deal to meet the concerns of MPs at Westminster. Critics of the deal are concerned the so-called Northern Ireland backstop could see the UK tied to the EU indefinitely. EU leaders have said the Prime Minister was not really clear in her Brexit demands at a summit last night. The telecoms regulator Ofcom is bringing in new rules to help broadband customers get the best deals available. It's found that half of UK homes could get a faster service than they do now, and sometimes at no extra cost. Ofcom's chief executive, Sharon White, says she hopes the rules will help millions of people who've ended up paying extra by staying loyal to one company.
For the first time ever, broadband providers will have to tell their customers when their contracts are coming to an end and the best prices. But today's campaign also means that in a very easy step, going to the website, boostyourbroadband.com, people can get the information they need to switch.
A former British soldier who was convicted in Turkey of being a member of a terrorist organisation has made a secret return to the UK. Joe Robinson was facing more than 7 years in prison for serving as a medic alongside Kurdish fighters in Syria. The public spending watchdog says the army has failed to meet its recruiting targets every single year since it outsourced the contract to the private company Capita. The National Audit Office found IT problems had left recruits waiting almost 11 months to start basic training. Many dropped out. Richard Bainham led the investigation at the Audit Office and said a high-tech system did not work.
Where they would recruit people and they would manage their applications online, they found that they still needed the face-to-face contact with applicants to see them through the process. They did shift back and are now providing an enhanced package of support at local offices.
Adverts which show a woman being unable to park a car or a man struggling to change a nappy are to be banned from next year. Under a new rule, drawn up by regulators, ads must not include gender stereotypes which are likely to cause harm or serious offence. And the weather, a cold start, but it will be dry, bright and sunny for most. That's the Six Music News. The next update's at 10:30.
This is BBC Radio 6 Music. Now on BBC Sounds.
Shaun! Six Music. Wait, 11 years presenting a breakfast show and you're throwing in the towel? Are you serious? 11 years, nothing. Try doing a breakfast show for 32 years, mate. 32 years. That's a proper innings. After 11 years of today, I was just getting into my stride. Still learning. Anyway, I wish you well. I reckon we shall always have those happy hours we spent together during your BBC training. I remember that first day you walked into my studio for How to Be a Breakfast Curmudgeon Module 1 course. Anyway, good luck, mate. And on the plus side, now that you are moving to the afternoon, I suppose I could start listening to your show. Not going to, but I could, I suppose. All the best. Turn off your mind, relax and float downstream.
Great, you know. I remember when me and John, you know, wrote that. Actually, it was John. You know, we were sitting on his bed, you know, in St. John's Wood, you know. And he said, I've got a great idea for a song. I said, great. Yeah, that was it. It's not very, that didn't make it into my autobiography, actually, that story.
That was, of course, The Beatles with Tomorrow Never Knows, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much to everybody who's getting in contact on our last breakfast show programme. How are you? Are you ready to go yet? I don't mean to go leave the building at the Legendary Midville Studios. I mean, I want to see you lachrymose.
Am I welling up?
You're not close yet, are you?
Not quite.
I've got a feeling you're going to be soon.
It's coming.
It is, mate. It is. And I'm going to facilitate that because... It is the most wonderful time of the year. We all know that. Big loves to everybody who has been in contact, to Peter and to Matthew and Shaun and to Greg in a cold Reading near Reading Bedding, just off the A4. To Letitia, to everybody here in Maida Vale 7. A massive round of applause to yourselves, please. You've really been a sensational audience. I wish we could do every radio programme in front of a live... Look at Phil's face. You must be bloody joking, mate. But now, to get you there, Matt, to make you true tears of Christmas joy, we have a special guest, a true troubadour, a style icon, a miscreant wrangling, star-spangling genius of the keys, with a voice like a agave syrup on an eclair. It's Ed Harcourt! Come on! Look at him! Don't you just want to eat him? Ed, thank you so much for coming in and doing this.
Thank you.
Where is he? I've not put his mic up.
Hang on. Hello.
Hang on. Where is he? No. Oh, this is good. What's that? That's quite nice. Honestly, to be fair though, Ed, we have been on air for 2 hours and 38 minutes and nothing's gone wrong yet. Has it? Has it really though? You know, in the pantheon of Six Music Breakfast shows, let's be honest, it's a signature of ours, isn't it? We have dead air, things go wrong, microphones don't work. It's just something that happens. But today it's been smoother than silk.
Smoother than it normally goes, until just that moment.
Which is slightly awkward. But we've got Ed. Ed, are you ready to give us some special Christmas vibes?
No.
No, he's not. That's a shame, isn't it? Well, I think that what we should do anyway is have a Silent Night sing-along and then get everybody else to sing and then we can hear the voice and the words. What about that? I'm going. Straight after this, we go completely Christmas.
Hope you're feeling groovy, because now it is time.
Hit it! The Craig Charles Funk and Soul Show.
Well, that'll be me. I've got this idea, though. I thought we'd get together and go 6, 7, 8, 9, bam! Banging tunes cranked up to the max. Heavy, heavy slices of funk. Dripping with soul. Can Saturday night get any better? Kick back and enjoy the vibes. Bumpty, bumpty, bump indeed. Just love this tune. These little drops of sunshine support your funk and soul. Getting ready to party. This is the Craig Charles Funk and Soul Show.
Every Saturday night from 6.
But make it funky.
BBC Radio 6.
Music.
The end of the broadcast right here. Oh my God, the red light's on.
Okay, I've stepped away from the cosy confines of my own studio desk to be bathed in the gorgeous aura of Ed Harcourt, ladies and gentlemen. And what it was there was it was my jack to jack that I brought in that was faulty. It wasn't pack tested, and that's why the Fender Rhodes wasn't working. I apologise about that, Ed. Now, just very quickly though, you've got a new album coming out, haven't you? Can you tell us a little bit about that, when it's out, and what it's like? That was a brilliant journal question, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's out already.
Well,
sure. You know, it's fine.
Bit ox, hashtag ox. Not done his research, and not for the first time, not for the last time. It's out now. We've all been enjoying it, but it's an instrumental album, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
So what? How come though? Why have you taken your gorgeous vocals off this one?
I was just bored of myself, to be honest. No, I just I was kind of going through a phase of writing just piano music, and then fortuitously got a call from my friend Rich, who runs this label, and he said, "Do you want to do an instrumental record?" Oh. I was like, "Yeah, I'm already doing it.
I'm already
let's go."
That's fortuitous.
Yeah.
We don't do birthdays, Ed.
Yeah.
But seeing as though this is the last 18 minutes of the breakfast programme that we're going to be delivering, on which there has been a moratorium on doing birthdays, we might have to lift it because I believe
it's my wife's birthday today. Yeah, my wife Geeta.
Anybody's birthday here today?
Yesterday. Yeah.
Yes, what's your name, sorry?
Alice.
Alice, okay. So for Alice, for Geeta, and for the baby Jesus, as Ed just pointed out, let's have a few stanzas of the song everybody knows.
Happy birthday to you.
We don't do them.
Happy birthday to you.
No exceptions.
Happy birthday, dear Geeta
and Alice and Jesus.
Happy birthday to you.
Yeah, beautiful. And we're going to have a song now. We were going to have two, but then because of my pack-tested lead, we can't do Silent Night. Let me just quickly tell the story, though. I was in a department store a couple of days ago, and Ed texted me, and he said, "Well, what song shall we do?" And as I walked into the department store, this song was playing, 2,000 Miles by the Pretenders, and I just said, "You know what? I think that I can really hear you singing that." And then you said...
I was on the phone to Chrissy Hynde.
Just as you do.
Part of my life.
Small claims court.
I don't like to brag, you know.
But you've got permission for her to do
Yeah,
this.
Basically, we're doing this benefit for Boxing Gym on Harrow Road, the All-Stars, on Sunday.
Yeah.
And she's playing, and we were just kind of emailing and texting and calling about the event. And then I just kind of said, "Oh, by the way, is it all right if I do 2,000 miles on Shaun's last show?" She was like, "Yeah."
Who the hell's Shaun?
So I got her blessing.
Right, well, we're going to do it. Well, take it away, please. 2,000 miles, Ed Harcourt.
Felt like Christmas time.
And I'll think of you wherever you go. He's gone 2,000 miles. It's very far. The snow is falling down. It gets colder by the day. I miss you. I can hear people singing. It must be Christmas time. I can hear people singing. It must be Christmas time.
Did it. You made Matt Everett cry. Ed Harcourt, ladies and gentlemen, that was just absolutely sensational and beautiful. Thank you. It is almost the end, but not quite. Let's hear Tom York, and then let's finish this thing.
Under my wings.
There it is. That was Tom York and Unmade. Face like an unmade bed, Shaun Keaveny. That's what they've been saying for the last 11 years. And they're absolutely right. We're here in MV7 with our dearly beloved. Can you please give us one more whoop? The all-day Christmas party continues with Lauren Laverne next, and then we're rolling into Rad Mac and to Steve bringing it on home all the way up till 7 o'clock.
What, sexually?
What can we say? I don't really know, to be honest. I mean, first of all, we've got to mention the cake. Can we have a round of applause? I've never applauded a cake before, but I'm going to do it now. The Six Music cake brought to us by Isabel. Apparently it's some kind of man versus food thing. I'm going to be filmed by the BBC News website immediately after this show, eating it all in 7 minutes. So that's something for you to look forward to. We'll visualise that and put it up on the socials. Just hello to everybody you know, who has been in contact on the programme. I'm going to do a little speech in a minute, but first of all, you can film this if you want and put it up on YouTube. Maybe we'll trend. You just never know, do you? Matt, final word from you before I go into my clawing masterpiece.
Thank you. It's been really amazing. And it will continue to be amazing. It'll be different, but it'll be amazing. And, yeah, that's the other thing that people often ask me is, oh, do you actually get on? It's like, yeah.
I know. Yeah. Apart from that Costa Coffee moment that we had to have on Great Portland Street in 2011, we had to have a word with ourselves.
That wasn't a pretty argument.
But no, apart from that, it's been really, let me get onto it, because I hope you don't mind. I usually just talk utter nonsense right off the top of me yed. But today I've prepared something. I can't believe we've done nearly 12 years of breakfast together. I'm talking about us all together, the listeners and everybody. Together we've seen 3 US presidents, one twice, 5 prime ministers, 113 leaders of UKIP. I took over from the much-loved Phil Jupiter, and of course, for a good while there, most people hated the change. We all hate it when change is foisted upon us, not of our choosing, I understand that. But I grew on you, insidious and malevolent and unwelcome, like a Japanese knotweed on a pristine lawn. Together we've constructed a silly alternate reality staffed by laughable idiots, and sprinkled with dad gags of differing qualities, and fueled by your sheer tolerance for mediocrity and your appetite for daftness. Thanks to the guests, the many wonderful people who've become our friends. Thanks to each and every producer and AP, some of which are here with us this morning, that have had to painstakingly find really stupid Jeremy Vine clips or a sound effect of an exploding whale once, I seem to remember. But a special thanks must go to Phil Smith, my carer, my dream weaver, to Zara, and of course, Matt Everett, the wind beneath my wings. He is my wind. He is one of my very best friends, and he makes me lol like a footballer on hippie crack. Without him, I literally would have another 19 minutes of dead air to fill every morning. And without him, I would be like Wings, not the Beatles. Finally, though, I just have to say thanks for giving me your time, listeners, your thoughts, for sharing your highs and your lows and your births, deaths and marriages, your middle-aged shout-outs and your small claims. And did you know I blanked Jude Law in this very building in 2013? It really did that. But I'll shut up now, because as Guy Garvey put it, Jesus, Shaun, you're only going to the afternoons. It's like saying you're moving to Australia and then moving 3 doors down. It's a bit awkward. So that is true. We decided what we're going to play to finish. So we decided that what we should do is play out the first song that we ever played on Breakfast back in 2007, April the 2nd, 2007. And for a long time, the tape was actually lost. It was, you know, one of those Hancock tapes, but not as good. But then we found it, and we blew off the dust, and we put it on, and we couldn't believe it. And this is true, and you can check this yourself, that the first song that we played on the Six Music Breakfast Show, April the 2nd, 2007, we're going to finish with now. It was Black Rebel Motorcycle Club and Stop.
Something people have been asking you to do for years.
So here it is. This is it. We'll see you on January the 7th, a different time slot. Our love to everybody, to Rad Mac, to Lauren, to Steve, to everybody.
It all is a sickness.
cats, maybe cats operating in gangs.
This is
BBC Radio 6 Music.
6 Music. 6 Music.
This afternoon from 4, Steve Lamack.
BBC Radio 6 Music.
At 1, Radcliffe and Marconi.
This is 6 Music.
Right now, it's Lauren Laverne.